So today we are going to talk about water-soluble vitamins. In last class, I told you about the fat-soluble vitamins, in which we already discussed that we are having the vitamin A, vitamin D, vitamin E, and vitamin K, right? So in today's class, we'll be talking about the water-soluble vitamins, okay? Water-soluble vitamins. So, which vitamins we are talking about? If we are talking about the water-soluble vitamins, vitamin C can be involved. Then vitamin B complexes, right? And which vitamin B complexes do we know? So vitamin B1, B2, let's name them as well. So B1 is also called as thiamine, right? Vitamin B2, riboflavin. Don't confuse this thiamine with thymine. Thiamine is kind of a nucleotide which we study in the biology, right? This is the thiamine, okay? Vitamin B2 is riboflavin. Vitamin B3 is niacin. We do not have vitamin B4. Then vitamin B5, also called as pantothenate or pantothenic acid. So pantothenate I'm writing over here. Then vitamin B6, also called as pyridoxine. Then we can say that we are having vitamin B7, also called as biotin. Okay, after that vitamin B9, folic acid. I told you about anemia. So in anemia, we already discussed B9, B12 deficiency anemia, right? Yeah. So after vitamin B9, vitamin B12, also called as cobalamin. Okay, vitamin B2 also called as cobalamin. So we are having water-soluble vitamins. So water-soluble vitamins, we are having the vitamin C and vitamin B complexes. Okay, in the vitamin B complexes, we are talking about vitamin B1, B2, B3, B5, B6, B7, B9 and B12. Okay, fine. So let's start with the vitamin C. Vitamin C, by the way, is also called as ascorbic acid. Very easy, right? Vitamin C is also called as ascorbic acid. Okay, a very famous disease due to the deficiency of vitamin C or ascorbic acid is scurvy. What is happening in this scurvy? Yeah, you're having the oral cavity problem, okay? So bleeding while brushing the teeth and all those things, right? Bruising, popliteal hemorrhage can be seen in the scurvy patients. So let's start with the vitamin C only. Vitamin C, also called as ascorbic acid, okay? So if you talk about the vitamin C, first of all, very, very important thing is it is helping us in converting dopamine to norepinephrine with the help of the stimulation of dopamine beta hydroxylase enzyme, okay? So what I'm saying, it is helping us in converting dopamine. You know, dopamine, you are in second year physiology, you are studying, right? Yeah, so in physiology, we talk about neurotransmitters. You know acetylcholine? Yeah, acetylcholine, we are talking about the epinephrine, norepinephrine, right? From the adrenal medulla, catecholamines are releasing, and epinephrine, norepinephrine is also called as catecholamines. So dopamine, we are having the epinephrine, norepinephrine, acetylcholine. These are the neurotransmitters inside the CNS, okay? So dopamine is actually converting into the norepinephrine in the adrenergic neurons. We are having two kinds of neurons, cholinergic and adrenergic neurons. Cholinergic neurons are regarding the parasympathetic nervous system. We all are aware about the parasympathetic and sympathetic nervous system. Cholinergic nervous system is regarding the parasympathetic nervous system. Adrenergic is regarding the sympathetic nervous system. Okay. So if I'm talking about the adrenergic system, I'm talking about sympathetic nervous system. Okay, what I'm saying is, first of all, acetylcholine, which you study as neurotransmitter, this is the neurotransmitter for the cholinergic system. For cholinergic system. If I'm talking about cholinergic system, I'm talking about parasympathetic nervous system. Okay, on the other hand, I can say norepinephrine is the neurotransmitter for adrenergic system. Adrenergic system. Now, adrenergic system means I'm talking about which system? Sympathetic nervous system. Right now, I'm talking about the conversion of dopamine into norepinephrine. So, I'm talking about adrenergic system. Dopamine converts into norepinephrine by the help of a special enzyme. And the name of this enzyme is dopamine beta hydroxylase. Okay? Dopamine beta hydroxylase. This process is happening inside the neuron. This process is happening inside the neuron. So, you must have aware about this thing. This is the presynaptic, postsynaptic, right? And inside it, we are having what? Presynaptic vesicle. Inside the vesicle, what is happening? We are having neurotransmitter. If I'm talking about adrenergic neuron, let's pretend this is adrenergic neuron. I can say this is norepinephrine. As the, this is, here is the calcium channels. As the action potential will be coming over here, these calcium channels will be voltage gated calcium channels will open up and calcium influx will be happening. What will be happening? Calcium influx will be happening. As the calcium influx will be happening, there will be the fusion of these vessels. There is the fusion of this vesicle with the presynaptic neuron. So, condition will be like this now. Right? Now, what will be happening? Due to this action potential, due to the influx of calcium ions, there will be the exocytosis. What does it mean, exo and endo? Exocytosis means, that is outside. Endocytosis means engulfing something. For example, macrophages engulf the bacteria. So, this is the endocytosis process. So, I am talking about the exocytosis, which means you are throwing out something. What you are throwing out? This neurotransmitter. If I'm talking about adrenergic neuron, I'm talking about norepinephrine. And here we will be having receptors which can bind over here. Okay, these are the presynaptic, this is the synaptic. If I'm talking about adrenergic neuron, I'm talking about alpha and beta. We are having two kinds of receptors. In alpha, we talk about alpha 1, alpha 2. Beta, we talk about beta 1, 2, 3. Okay, you should not bother about that one. You will be studying this thing in pharmacology next year. Okay, I'm not talking about the receptor now, but this thing you should know. So, what I want to say is that first of all, norepinephrine is there. From where it is coming? It is coming from where? It is coming from dopamine. Okay? And dopamine, from where it is coming? It is coming from levodopa. So, this dopamine which is converting into norepinephrine, it is converting with the help of what? It is converting with the help of beta hydroxylase. Actually, we call this as dopamine beta hydroxylase. Okay, this one, dopamine beta hydroxylase. Now understood? So vitamin C is very crucial in this conversion process. Okay, fine. So you should remember this thing. Then what can we say about this one? So we know, we are aware of very important problem. So first of all, let's talk about the causes. Vitamin C, what are the sources of the vitamin C? Citric fruits, citrus, so lemons, oranges, guava, all these things, right? So all this sore kind of things are the sources for the vitamin C. Okay, now where we may have the deficiency of these things. So I'm writing over here. So I'm talking about the deficiency of vitamin C now. So what can be the causes over here? Okay, what can be the causes? So causes, first of all, smoking is the biggest cause for most of the problem happening inside our body. So cigarette smoking, in fact, cigarette smoking and all these things, smoking is the risk factor for many kind of disease. It can be heart problem, it can be liver problem, it can be kidney problem, it can be lungs problem, every kind of problem. Smoking is the risk factor for most of the problems. So smoking is the problem. Then if the patient is lacking citrus diet, for example, citrus fruit and all these things, if the patient is lacking in taking that, then the patient may be having. And one more very important thing is the, you know, in the children, they are having the vitamin C deficiency because the mothers, if the mother is boiling, you know, they are taking the formulas. Okay, the milk formulas, I'm saying. So, you know, excessively boiled formulas, in that content, if you are boiling too much, if you're boiling that milk formulas too much, you are depleting the amount of vitamin C. So in those cases, what is happening? Vitamin C deficiency can be seen easily in those children. So excessive boiled formula can lead to vitamin C deficiency as well. Okay, so these can be the things, these can be the risk factors, causes for the vitamin C deficiency. So what can be the clinical presentation, how the patient will be having the symptoms and all. So let's talk about those things as well. So talking about the symptoms, so you know, we are talking about scurvy. This is the major problem which is happening in the vitamin C deficiency. So what can we say about the scurvy? You know, there can be the chances of increasing the bruising. What are the bruising? There are the chances of bleeding from the skin surfaces. Okay, so these chances can be increased. Second thing, perfollicular hemorrhage can be increased. These chances can be increased of perfollicular hemorrhage. This is also same kind of a thing. So, you know, your skin, if there is having some kind of rubbing or this some kind of friction is happening to the skin, then easily it might lead to bleeding. Okay, then bleeding from the gums. Okay, bleeding from the gums while brushing the teeth and all. Okay, then in some cases glossitis can be seen. In some cases chelitis can be seen. What is glossitis? Inflammation of tongue. What is chelitis? Inflammation of lips. Okay, stomatitis can also be seen in some cases. Bleeding time can increase in some cases. Okay, bleeding time may increase in some cases. And one very, very important, you know, these kind of patients, if you talk about the hairs present on the hands and legs and all, okay, on the extremities, they are having some specific kind of patterns that is also called as pinwheel pattern. Which pattern? Pinwheel kind of pattern. Okay, or you can say cork screw shaped. Corkscrew shape. For an example, if this is the extremity over here, okay, let's pretend. So over here, what you can say, they are having specific kind of curly kind of formation. This is the corkscrew shaped pattern or pinwheel shaped pattern present on the extremities, on the skin surface. Okay, seen in which deficiency? Vitamin C or ascorbic acid deficiency. Okay, I'm